I'm Sean O'Brien with O'Brien Septic and Portable Toilets out of Nunday, New York. We've been in business for about 10 years, and my wife, Kathy O'Brien, is the actual owner of it, and I work for her. Lucky me, right? We're at a job now that we pulled over right around the corner from the house. We just drove the backhoe over here. We're going to actually do a little tree work while we're here, but that's kind of what we did here. We just scratched the top of that tank off. And then pumped it. It's only a 500-gallon tank, but it definitely needed to be pumped. It was probably a couple foot of solids in the bottom of it.
Last year, I came over and found it for them, but they wanted to wait till the spring to get it done. I knew I was only going to need a couple lengths of hose to get started here. We'd like to look at both sides. On this particular tank, it was a 500-gallon tank. There's an inlet and an outlet baffle on it. We kind of like to do a visual of them, so we had to clean off both covers. Some tanks, you're not that fortunate, but this one was good to go. Yeah, well, once I get the hoses all hooked up, I like to put vacuum on the truck before I pull the cap on it. So just in case there's any residue in the cap, I don't get it on the customer site. You know, once we get down to the bottom of the tank, I like to run some water in it. We're not fortunate enough here to have an outside spigot. So right now, we're trying to run some water from the house into the tank to try to get some of the solids off the bottom. This tank hasn't been serviced in quite a while. This house was vacant for quite a few years, so there's no floaties at all on this tank. Everything had deteriorated, dropped down in the bottom of the tank, so it was pretty thick. I'm mixing it up. I got a big spoon that I like to use. It does a great job on mixing all the solids up in the bottom, so it's a little easier for the truck to pump it. Yeah, we're on the bottom of the tank now. I'm just trying to get a little bit more of the solids out of the bottom of the tank before we wrap the hoses up. And we're all done. I like to roll the hoses up, try to get most of the residue out of it. This particular job, I don't have any water. And then what I usually do is put a little vac on the truck, or close the suction valve, let it draw a little more vacuum on the truck, and then suck a little bit more of the residue through it, trying to keep it off the customer's grass. Yeah, normally this tank was so shallow to the ground, it just happened to, like I think I told you before, we just happened to be over here. We're going to clear some trees for this customer, so we wanted to. Since it was here, we closed up the hole with the backhoe and just kind of swept it over there.
I'm Sean O'Brien with O'Brien Septic and Portable Toilets, located in Nunday, New York. My wife actually established the business in 2003, and we just acquired another company in June of last year, which was Brown Septic Service out of Alfred Station. Right now, we're standing in front of a job. It was a real estate inspection, and we found that the septic tank was actually leaching into a creek, that a little stream that runs by the property. So we ended up having to replace put a new leach field in. We ended up putting a pump tank in because of this grade. It's an odd grade here, so we had to put a pump tank in, and I got the health department showing up right now to do a final inspection.